Welcome to Roboy's Research Reviews, or the Projects R3. This is a new initiative of Roboy where we bring you state-of-the-art research and try to explain it to you within this short video. But before presenting a very interesting paper in robotics, let me introduce Roboy to you. Roboy is a humanoid robot that we are building to understand how the human body works. What makes Roboy really special and stand out from the other robots worldwide is that he has muscles and tendons instead of electrical engines in the joints. That results in many advantages as it comes to exploring the human-machine interaction. Roboy is built by a team of students and researchers, mostly from the Technical University of Munich, and it's an open source project, so if you are interested, check out our website roboy.org or the GitHub account github.com/roboy. In this video, we want to introduce the research on spatiotemporal epidural electrical stimulation. Spinal cord injuries can be debilitating, resulting in permanent loss of leg control. These papers look at restoring leg functionality to allow patients to walk again with epidural electrical stimulation, or EES. This is a technique in which an electrode array connected to a small pulse generator is surgically implanted over the lower spinal cord. The electrodes recruit afferent nerve fibers, or nerves that convey the body's status to the central nervous system to send signals. Most medical implementations of EES have used continuous EES, in which the current is continuously applied to the spine. However, these papers look at an alternative technique known as spatiotemporal EES. First, we want to focus on continuous EES. In animals, continuous EES has been successful in restoring the ability to stand, walk, or even run. However, the effect in humans has been more limited. It has restored the ability to perform rhythmic and independent leg motions, but hasn't been able to restore independent weight-bearing motion. The theory as to why this discrepancy occurs is that the signals sent along the afferent nerves by continuous EES collide with the signals being sent by the body, which cancels out both signals. These nerves are significantly longer in humans than in most test animals, and these signals occur more often, meaning there's a much greater chance of collision. In computer models, the probability of collisions for rats topped out at about a 20% chance, whereas in humans, this probability reached nearly 100%. Spatiotemporal EES differs from continuous EES in that spatiotemporal EES recruits different patterns matching the stimulation profiles of muscles. This still resulted in collisions that cancelled signals being sent along the efferent nerves. However, these signals were replaced by the spatiotemporal EES signals. The testing of spatiotemporal EES in humans was done by building an atlas of which portions of the spinal cord were activated during muscle movements in healthy persons, which was then personalized to each patient through the use of magnetic resonance imaging. This was used to determine electrode placement. It then took roughly 5 days to build up the stimulation profiles necessary for the EES to function, that is, creating EES sequences that could trigger specific movements in the legs. Once this was done, all participants of the study regained some control of their leg muscles, being able to walk with support for over 1 kilometer on a treadmill, adjust their stride lengths, and stop despite ongoing stimulation. Within 1 to 3 months of rehabilitation, all subjects were able to walk with hands-free gravity assistance. The results prove that spatiotemporal EES is a promising avenue of research to restore mobility in paralyzed persons. With this large number of degrees of freedom, a flexible spine is a complex system and is involved in almost every movement. The Roboy team is trying to get a deeper understanding of how the human body works in order to build better, more useful robots by adopting principles from biology, and to help humans with musculoskeletal limitations through better prosthetics, better training, and exoskeletons.
So the main motivation for the spine of Robo 2.0 was that it should be human-inspired, should be as flexible as the human body. It should be made out of polymer printed, and it should support the entire body. So for a humanoid robot, the spine is very important because in every motion of the arms, for example, the spine is included a little bit to make it more natural.
Roboy employs a revolutionary new framework for agile hardware development, combined with a vision-based approach to advance along its roadmap. A robot as good as the human body. Thanks for watching another episode of R Cubed. See you soon and stay curious.